Simon & Schuster Audio presents A Noob's Diary of an 8-Bit Warrior Collection, Books 1 through 3, by Cube Kid, performed by Michael Gallagher. Monday. Welcome to our village. Around here, we're defenseless against creatures. Well, against monsters, to be more specific. They come every night, and all we can do is hide in our little houses. If only we could fight them. Sadly, villagers aren't allowed to. I live in a village of scaredy cats. We've built high walls to protect ourselves from monsters. They're everywhere at night, and we like to stay safe and scared in our homes instead of facing them. It's ridiculous. I'd rather fight, face these monsters, so they finally leave us alone. But nobody takes me seriously in the village. One of the reasons why is my name. Why did my parents think calling me Runt was a good idea? With that kind of name, of course everyone thinks I'm a noob. But if I could battle a monster, they'd finally see me as I really am, a warrior. But sadly, villagers never become warriors. All they care about is staying safe, cooped up in the village, and earning emeralds. Everyone tells me that I should be a farmer like my parents, have a good job worthy of a villager. But I dream of more. Steve is my idol. He's a warrior, and he's so cool. He's got style and a diamond sword he can defeat any monster with. That's so much cooler than being a farmer, isn't it? I'm still far away from that dream. I can't stand the thought of becoming a farmer. I want to be a warrior just like Steve. But villagers never become warriors. This morning, I made a huge mistake at school. We were doing a really simple mining exercise, but I forgot to repair my pickaxe. Of course, it broke and went flying toward the teacher's head. Luckily, he wasn't hurt. But my pride wasn't as lucky. The whole class made fun of me. Runt the Noob strikes again. This afternoon, we had the only cool class of the week, mob defense.
Today, we're going to study Endermen, the teacher said.
All the other students shivered. Not me. I was excited.
They're dangerous creatures that will attack you if you look them in the eye, she continued. Despite that, warriors hunt them down for those very eyes. That's because an eye of Ender can open a portal to the end, the dragon's lair.
I took meticulous notes. I learned this super fancy word in class yesterday. It means something like careful. To be honest, I pay more attention and I focus more in this class than anywhere else.
What are villagers supposed to do if we run into an Enderman? The teacher asked.
Max, a kid in class who likes making fun of me, said we should sell him pants because with legs that long, we'd make a lot of emeralds. Of course, everyone laughed, except me. This is a serious topic. I couldn't help myself. No, we attack them. We attack them, I yelled. The teacher covered her mouth in shock.
None of that. Attack an Enderman? Never. If you see one, run. Do you hear me, Runt?
Everyone looked at me and laughed. None of them think I could be a warrior. And I'm going to prove them all wrong. I'm tired of it. That was it. I decided to get out of there that night. My friend Stump didn't think it was a good idea.
We're not allowed to leave the village, Runt, he said.
I told him it would be fine, that Steve had taught me how to craft a wooden sword when he was last here. Stump thinks I'm such a noob, but I know how to defend myself. I even said he could come with me, but of course that big chicken said no. I guess I can only count on myself. Later that evening, I packed my bag, making sure I didn't forget my wooden sword. I waited until it was dark out and my parents' backs were turned to sneak out of the house. I was trying to make as little noise as possible when suddenly,
Runt!
I jumped out of my skin and turned around. It was Stump.
Not so loud. Can't you tell I'm trying to sneak out?
Exactly, he replied. I wanted to say goodbye.
Thanks. Wait, what do you mean goodbye?
You're going out there at night with a wooden sword to fight all those monsters. Sorry, but I wouldn't bet an emerald on you making it back in one piece.
Thanks, Stump. He walked with me to the village wall, then sold me a ladder to climb up it. Villagers don't change their ways, even for friends. Once up there, I saw the moonlit horizon stretch before me. Out there was adventure. I finally felt like I was somewhere I belonged. That didn't last. Once I was outside the village, it got really dark. At first, everything was fine. Then, I heard a terrible noise. I started shaking all over. I turned around and was face to face with a zombie. A real one, all green, wearing torn clothes. Disgusting and smelly. Gross. I closed my eyes for a few seconds. What if Stump was right? What if my wooden sword wasn't enough? No, he was wrong. I am a warrior. I tightened my grip on the handle of my sword and bravely ran forward, then turned around and ran away lightning fast. I've never run that fast, leaving most of my stuff behind. Luckily, my diary was safe in my pocket. At least I didn't lose everything. After that, I went back home, coming in less than an hour after sneaking out, like a noob. My parents were still at the dinner table when I got home. My mother was worried and asked me to explain, but I couldn't. I just ran into my room without saying a word. I climbed into bed and curled into a ball, still in my torn and filthy clothes. I'm so embarrassed. Everyone was right about me. I'm just a noob, a loser, a failure, a villager like all the others, incapable of defending himself, unable to even take down a lone, lost zombie. Nothing like Steve. Steve, now there's a true hero. He would have crushed that zombie in a matter of seconds. Everyone's going to laugh tomorrow at school when Stump tells them how he tricked me into buying a ladder and how he saw me coming home only an hour later, like a big loser. Max is going to love this too. I'll never be a powerful warrior like Steve. I might as well get used to the idea. Tuesday. This morning, when I got up, I was a bit less upset than yesterday. My first big adventure didn't really go as planned. But I'm still in one piece, right? And I guess I should expect that being a warrior is hard. Otherwise, everyone would do it. I bet Steve has bad days, too. And getting back up to fight again is what makes a great warrior. So that's what I decided to do this morning. I wasn't really being brave. I was actually scared of going back to school. I didn't want to deal with Max or Stump making fun of me. The next time they'd see me, I'd be a mighty warrior. Then they wouldn't laugh at me anymore. They'd bow before me. But before that, I'd have to prove myself. I made myself another bag to replace the one I lost yesterday, put everything I needed in it, and crafted a new wooden sword. It's not the most effective weapon, but it works. When I was ready, I walked out of my room, trying to look normal. "Have a good day, Runt. See you tonight," my parents said. "Yeah, see you tonight." They looked at me funny, so I rushed off, slamming the door behind me. So much for not drawing attention to myself. Instead of going to school, I headed out of the village. I hugged the village walls, trying to avoid everyone from school. I didn't want to bump into Stump or worse, Max. Luckily, I didn't encounter anyone, and I managed to slip quietly out of the village. Once outside, I took a deep breath. The monsters needed to watch out for me this time. I was more determined than ever. They were going to get it. But first, before I attacked anyone, I had to find a quiet and safe place to set up camp. I soon found the perfect place, right at the edge of the forest, not too far from a series of caves. I got to work. I carved out a small space in the rock. I even put in a door. Outside, I crafted a...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.